Hello. Are you bored? Are you entertained? No? Well then, that sucks. Boredom is a quintessential part of living in our modern age. You know, boredom is a crime and all that. Anyone that was stuck inside during 2020 would know exactly what this feeling is, exactly how dangerous, scary, and effective it can be at making us want to scratch our brains out of our head holes. So, with the nature of art, and creating things based on life, we were inevitably going to try and recreate those feelings in our media. But why would anyone choose to be bored? Why on earth would anyone choose to lie in that waste of time and space? Why in the fucking world would anyone, want to play a boring game? Death Stranding is commonly poked out as a classic boring game. You play as Norman Reedus as you deliver common packages across a vast wasteland while taking care of a tank baby, on a journey to reconnect a world that has been ravished by isolation and societal destruction, all while the line between life and death is ominously severed. It's quite strange. Many praise it and others laugh at its expense, amazed that such a boring game about walking from point A to point B would be enjoyed by so many. I'm not here to tell you that if you don't like Death Stranding, you're wrong. That would be stupid and silly. Some people don't want to play a game like this, and that's okay. But why do people even enjoy it at all? The game consists of segments where you walk from place to place, avoiding threats, taking care of all your different packages that you carry with you. The game is divisive not because its story is bad, or because it's not well made, or because it's a cash grab, etc. Especially after Kojima was kicked off the Metal Gear Solid games, people had high expectations for his next big game. It's because 90% of the game is downtime. The space between the story segments can feel grueling, long, and very boring. You'll get a fun cutscene where Del Toro and Reedus kiss in the shower.
No one can spy on us in here. It's just you and me.
But then you're cut off, forced to walk a few miles before you can get back to the, quote, good part. But for me, the good part is just one facet of what makes Death Stranding so unique. Most games tread downtime like dead air in radio or streaming, but Death Stranding revels in each and every small moment. From each step you take, to the vista you look at while traveling, to tripping on a small rock and falling headfirst into a river.
Get it together.
Yes, Death Stranding is boring. Its developers even internally referred to it as a walking simulator, which is apt. But is that a bad thing? Is the game worse because it asks you to invest time into it?
How you doing,
Sam? That's entirely subjective. Everyone lives their own life. But I really enjoy the time I spent with Death Stranding. I mean, I beat it 3 times, so it must have something worthwhile. Despite it being boring, I'm drawn to it. It's something to do while you listen to a podcast, wind down, just play some video games. Simple tasks to complete. In today's world, I've come to appreciate that mundanity in my media. Sometimes, I want to use 100% of my brain to curb-stomp enemies into nothing. Other times, I just want to sit down, relax, and do some laundry. Arcade Paradise is a game about owning and running a laundromat. You do laundry, clean up trash, clean the toilet, and all the other fun stuff that comes with running a business in 1990. You also run a little arcade in the back room. The game is beautiful, drenched in great style and some really high-quality sound design and animation. It's a game that some consider boring. The main task is about doing a boring, repetitive thing over and over and over. But the small twist to Arcade Paradise that makes it special is the fact that it chooses to be realistically optimistic about the 90s instead of the Stranger Things 3 approach of blind nostalgia with plenty of colors and happy music. The game opens with your character, Ashley, waking up, putting on some hard rock and heading into her new job as the owner and caretaker of a laundromat her dad gave her. Sorry, did I say gave? I meant forced upon her.
Hello, Ashley. This is your father calling. Welcome at long last to the real world and real responsibility. King Laundry was among my first investments in Grindstone. Not an important one. I'm pleased you're taking... taking this seriously. As a reward, I will no longer be keeping tabs. Just keep it tidy. I'm sure I can trust you to do that much.
The moment you walk in, your dad gives you this tutorial spiel that reads like he hates you for existing, patronizing you by explaining simple tasks with passive aggression. The newspapers you collect to throw out talk about distant horrors that just barely don't affect your time at the Kingwash. The streets are littered with graffiti and suburban rot. Yet your character is able to find immense joy in the most basic of tasks. In between washes, you can head to the back and play some arcade games, take care of the place, complete little goals you set for yourself. My personal favorite is when you need to clean the toilet, usually a daunting and disgusting task. But here, it's a game. In fact, every time I see that the washroom is broken, I get so excited. Taking on that toilet like a knight at arms, damage numbers pop up, rapid clicking and arcade sounds emanate from your character's brain. A narration voice shouts out, "Toilet defeated!" in a gnarly way.
System subjugated!
I love cleaning shit out of the dirty shit toilet.
It's fun, somehow. The game even gives you an achievement for doing nothing all day. Existential dread. This goes for every task you perform in Arcade Paradise. Picking up trash feels like finding a coin in Mario. Throwing the garbage in the trash is a switch and a flick, with satisfying rankings for each task you complete. S on the trash takeout, S on the arcade cleanup. When you pick up loose gum stuck to the chairs and machines, it says, "Hidden package collected." The game is somehow fun despite that it's a routine, day after day doing the same thing. Your dad telling you how lazy and stupid you are. But there's hope. You can actually make a great amount of money from the arcade in the back. People put their clothes into the wash and then head into the back to play some Zombat 2. It makes a pretty good profit. This game is also boring, yet it finds immense meaning and joy in the mundane and repetitive. It encourages you to enjoy doing what you love and to try to work the same way. Find ways to make life fun. Gamify it, if you will. The small moments, while annoying and constantly interrupting my game of Racer Chaser, they're also a nice break. Because the mundane is becoming increasingly rare as the world continues to run faster and faster and faster.
Is your life too perfect? In a world where everyone is perfect, get ready to experience imperfection. Introducing Bordeaux. Equip your senses. Experience mediocre reality. This is the very simple introduction to a weird little game called Bordeaux, created by a very teeny tiny small little guy, Goblin Rage. Literally small, this game only has like 25 reviews on Steam, which is a shame because it's just as meaningful as it is stupid and nonsensical. Despite it only being about an hour long, in a world where everything is perfect, mediocre reality becomes a commodity, a spectacle, a drug, quite literally. A dome-shaped pill that you take to enter the Bordeaux interactive experience, where you move from dome to dome, tasting the boring and disappointing and inconvenient like it's wine at a bougie restaurant. It's also a perfect bit generator.
I will strike down my future self. My mistakes shall become undone. Whose is this? Is this mine?
What? This is a really funny image. It smells like shit! Shit, it smells like shit! You smell like shit! Thank you. I didn't know that.
Ha ha ha.
That's what fucking happens when you get in my way.
What? What's the problem? What's going on here? Hey! Hey, what? Am I ruining the experience? I'm gonna get him. I'm gonna fucking get him. We need more. Hello? I'm your Uber Eats? Hello, I'm your Uber Eats.
Oh.
My guy, you're not allowed to go in. He invited me in. You know, no? Here, shut the door. Hey, you can't come in here, man. Hey! I'm going in. I can't deal with it. The easy win dome offers you the simple and amazing opportunity to win easily. Are you tired of trying? Just win. Oh my god!
Oh my god! Look! I win!
Eternity. It smells like eternity, and also shit. It smells like shit.
The absurdity of the game gives it this external feel. I truly believe that anyone playing this game will act unhinged and strange just by design. The game has you enter a dome where you confront an excrement. Will you step on it? Smell it? Be generally grossed out by its existence? You're the artist here, the game repeats. With another room, you enter to see a performance doing a little dance. You unlock the ability to clap and can enter and interrupt the show. The interruption dome, they call it. Giving you that awkward sense of being wrong. That horrible feeling in your stomach that has become oh so rare in this perfect world, theoretically. It's fascinating. Is this what we will be eventually? Desperately clinging to things that were once loathed? The Dome of Boredom is a fascinating human experience. It takes something so simple and overlooked in our lives and commodifies it into something valuable. A personal favorite dome of mine is the Happy Birthday Dome. You enter and immediately see a little guy standing in this room, and you unlock the empathy ability. It's his birthday. They're alone on this wonderful day. But using empathy, you can see through their eyes, and they see a room filled with other little fellas that look exactly the same. Populating their own birthday party with themselves. It's so simple, yet viscerally effective. Another dome is just an existential crisis generator.
Whoa, whoa, What the fuck? What the fuck? What? 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 What?
Another dome. A massive hill with a rock at the top. It smells like eternity in here. And shit, there's still shit on my hands. It smells like shit. Pushing the boulder down, you're never able to push it back to the top. No matter how hard you try, how many moves you use, how much you cry or leave. The boulder's still there, and you'll never get out up that hill. There's also a room where you can spawn a million flies and crash the game. This sharp switch between the absurd, the mundane, and existentially terrifying is almost unnoticeable. The game doesn't seem to care if you're having fun or gaining anything from each dome. It simply exists for you to participate in if you're looking for it. These boring experiences are special because of their mundanity. If they were action-packed or extremely interesting, then they wouldn't be as much of the anomalies as they are. There's many more boring games out there. So many. Weird games hidden in the shadows of the internet. These experiences are something I really value in games nowadays. With all the aggressive, self-interested criticism in the world today, it's nice to see games like these that are willing to challenge why we play games. Why do we, at least some of us, value these experiences as much as we do? Well, personally, it's because in today's world, we're constantly told about how much time we have left, constantly reminded of the ridiculous mundanity of the world, somehow horrifying and expected at the same time. Seeing that represented in a fictional reality is comforting to me. It helps me understand my place in this thing we call the world. In the last two domes of Boredom, you're greeted by a mirror. After everything, the flies, the library, the smoking, and the mundane stupidity, your character looks broken, beat down, tired. You look much like the statue at the beginning that you tried to strike down with a sword enthusiastically, but the sword breaks. You can't kill your future self. The next room is empty and dark and nothing. It's an empty room with a camera that slowly pans out. It smells like boredom.
Alright, video's over now. You can leave. It's done. There isn't anything here, alright? Go watch one of my other videos, maybe. Fuck. I'm fucking tired.